blob of seaweed twice the width of the United States is heading toward Florida. This is it on the satellite images. Now, we don't know how bad it's going to impact our coastline, but scientists are starting to warn that this sargassum could bring deadly flesh-eating bacteria with it called Vibrio vulnificus. You probably heard about it before. It kills about 1 in 5 people infected. So far this year, 3 people in Lee County have been infected. NBC2's Ryan Arbogast is on Naples Beach tonight with the warning from health officials.
We're being as careful as possible here, but you could bring this bacteria home with you without even knowing it. All you have to do is have an open sore on your body and step into the infected water or come in contact with this seaweed.
There's no out of the woods. We don't know when it's going to come or if it's going to come. It's a 50-50 chance.
FGCU Water School professor Barry Rosen says it's a coin flip on whether or not we will see this 5,000-mile-wide sargassum blanket make its way to the Paradise Coast. These satellite images from the University of South Florida show where it is right now, creating this mess along the shores of the Florida Keys.
When it starts to decay, just like anything that washes up on the shore, it can start to smell.
But new research from Florida Atlantic University shows the bloom could be carrying a dangerous passenger. As the sargassum drifts through the Atlantic Ocean, it slowly picks up microplastics. Those particles act as a glue, letting Vibrio vulnificus tag along for the ride.
Vibrio vulnificus presents itself with a warm red, sometimes swelling in the area. People who do contract Vibrio vulnificus may undergo amputation, and 1 in 5 people who do contract Vibrio vulnificus will unfortunately pass away.
Getting infected with the flesh-eating bacteria is unfortunately easy. Vibrio can enter your bloodstream with simple contact to an open wound, transmitted via the water, the sand, or the seaweed itself.
If you have any open cuts, sores, wounds, even if you have shaved your legs, Vibrio vulnificus can enter your body.
During the aftermath of Hurricane Ian, Charlotte, Lee, and Collier counties saw 32 confirmed cases of the bacteria due to runoff and pollution. The CDC says on average out of 80,000 cases, about 100 people die from this every single year. If the sargassum hits our coast, Professor Rosen says, please stay off the beach.
I wouldn't touch it. Leave it to the authorities to clean it up.
This sargassum isn't part of the bloom, but FGCU researchers say there's about a 50-50 chance we'll actually see an impact. Things like the tides and winds can move this bloom considerably. We should have a better idea on if we're going to see anything at all in the next coming months. I'm reporting local today on Naples Beach. Ryan Arbogast, NBC2.